हरिः ओम् श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयम् करुणालयम् नमामि भगवत्पादशङ्करम् लोकशङ्करम् शङ्करम् शङ्कराचार्यम् केशवम् बादरायणम् सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः नारायणम् नमस्कृत्य नरम् चैव नरोत्तमम् देवीम् सरस्वतीम् व्यासम् ततो देवोदीरयेत् श्रीगणेशशारदागुरुभ्यो नमः शिवाय गुरवे नमः टुडेस् वर्सेस् Dharmagup, Dharmakrit, Dharmi, Sadasaksharam Aksharam, Abhijnata Sahasramshuhu, Vidhata Kritalakshanaha, Dharmagup, Dharmakrit, Dharmi, Sat Asat Ksharam Aksharam, Abhijnata Sahasramshuhu, Vidhata Kritalakshanaha. These are the names. The first name is Dharmagup. So there are two words in it. The first part is called Dharma, the second part is Gup. Gup comes from a verb called Gup Rakshane. Gup means protect. What does Gupta do? He protects. Gopi, Gopakha, what does he do? Protects the cow. What does a Gopi do? Protect the cow. And what is Vishnu? Dharma Gup. He protects Dharma. That is why he is called Dharmagup. How does he protect Dharma? By avatara karma. How does he protect Dharma? By avatara karma. By doing a karma called avatara. Ava means down. Tara means come. So he comes down.
Yada yada hi dharmasya glanir bhavati bharata. Abhyutthanam adharmasya tadatmanam srijamyam.
Whenever there is the requirement of dharma samsthapana, when there is more adharma, when the bad guys create imbalance between dharma and adharma, then he takes an avatara and comes and sustains, he brings up dharma back. That is how he is a protector of dharma. And avataras are also, there are Leela avataras, Vyuha avataras, Avesha avataras. Avesha means they can come into somebody's body and make them act. They can become a Vivekananda or a Narendra Modi or a Ramakrishna. All these people he can become. Means his Vibhuti. Vibhuti means a little bit like the priest, they take the mango leaves, dip it in the pot, everybody is lining up. One drop falls. Like that, when Bhagavan does that, if one drop falls on that person, he gets an avesha. He will feel very committed. He is not in anybody's payroll. He simply wants to project dharma. Why is he doing that? Because of that inner happiness. Prachodayat. From his inside, Bhagavan does prerana. Because every time somebody happens, he cannot come and attend it. For little things, he would create this Avesha avataras. He would inspire people and make them fight for dharma. That is why in somehow he protects this dharma. That is why he is called as Dharmagup. The next one is Dharmakrit. Why does he protect dharma? Because he is Dharmakrit. He is the one who made it in the first place. What is dharma? Constitution of this world. The world rotates, functions in a very orderly fashion. As though there is some unwritten rule. As though there is some unwritten rule, the sun comes up daily up. Every 6 months you have got seasons. Every 2 months there is a change in seasons. All this happens in an orderly fashion, as though somebody is following this law. This law is called as dharma. And he is that dharma krita. He makes that law. He writes those rules. That is why he is Dharmagupa. Because he is the writer of the constitution. Naturally, the enforcer is also him. That is why he is dharma krita. Now, you told me that Bhagavan is nirguna. Bhagavan does not have an eye, because he is the eye of the eye. Bhagavan does not have a hand, because he does not have a form. then why is he concerned about dharma in this world?
Because dharma dharma vihinopi, that's what Shankara writes. Though he does not have dharma or adharma in him,
dharma maryada samsthapayati. He always is interested in maryada. What is maryada? Moral order. How do you know that? Because every avatara of Bhagavan has always functioned in a very orderly fashion. He always goes after the bad people and vanquishes them. So, he himself, he does not require dharma. He does not require to follow adharma or dharma. He does not have a requirement. He is above the law, as some people think. He is really above the law. He is not thinking. Bhagavan is above the law because he is the creator of the law. He says that in the Gita. What does he say? Name parthasti kartavyam. Hey partha, mama kartavyam nasti. I don't have a 40-hour week. I don't have a time schedule. Because kartavyam nasti. What is kartavyam? Kartavyam means duties. Morning you should get up and get milk in India. You have to stand in the queue and get milk. That's the first duty of the husband. After that you have to do suprabhatam. Otherwise the milk lorry will go away. So you have a series of kartavyam. What is this kartavyam? What you are kartum yogyam, what you are supposed to do. Everybody has got that. The son has got a kartavyam. He cannot come at 8 o'clock. Trump will fire him. Vishnu will fire him. Bhishasmad vatah pavate. The Vayu cannot go southwest if he is supposed to go northeast. So everybody has to follow dharma. Vayu has got a kartavyam. But Krishna says, Bhagavan Paramatma says, Name parthasti kartavyam trishu lokeshu kinchana. In these three worlds, I don't have any kartavyam, nothing to do. Why? Nana vaptavam avaptavyam. Why do you do kartavyam? What is it that motivates you to get that milk? There is some motivation. Either a stick or a carrot. It can be a carrot or a banana. But Krishna does not have neither. Why? Na anattam avaptavyam. There is nothing for me to attain. There is no motivation because I don't have kama. He is Kameshwara. He is the lord of all desires. Because he does not have desire, he does not have duty. As long as you have bills to pay, you need a pay slip. As long as you have a pay slip, you have to do your job. But Krishna is not after pay slip. Paramatma is avaptavyam nakimapi nasti. Hence, name partha asti kartavyam. Then Arjuna's counter question. Why did you create me? What is the reason I am here? He says, Yadihyaham navarteyam jadukarmanya tandritaha. Tandri. Tandri means alasi, lazy. If I become, go and sit in that furniture, lazy boy. If I do that, Imaha lokaha utsidehu. The entire creation will come to a standstill. The Surya will not do his duty. Yama will stop killing people. The entire planet will be with uninsured old people. If Yama is not doing his job. So, Imaha lokaha utsidehu. The moral order of this universe will come to a standstill. Na kuriyam karma chedaham. And not only that, Upahanyami ima prajaha. The entire humanity will follow me. Because yadyad acharati sreshtaha tattadeva itare janaha. Whatever I do, the people will follow. My bhaktas will follow. And all others will start following me. That is why even though I have nothing to do with this world, I have no kama, still to keep you all in good humor, I keep on doing my homework. I do my duty. That is why he is called dharma krita. Though he does not have to deal with dharma and adharma, he is the dharma karta for the creation's sake, for our sake. That is why he is dharmagup, dharma krita. Third one is dharmi. What is the meaning of dharmi? Dharman dharayati. See, there was a period in our family where our ancestors did a lot of good work. Disproportionately they did good. They did little bit of bad and a lot of good. Now the cycle has come the other way. We are completely into sensual enjoyment and do very little spiritual things. Only 1% of spirituality, 99% of conception. So what happened to all dharma? Dharma is with dharmi. This dharmi means the person who holds dharma eternally. So Vishnu is holding in your genes, in your DNA. So you have got your forefathers, you are great dharmis in your genes. So all your life you did not do dharma, but your great grandson will continue. He will become a Prahlada. So who is holding this dharma inside him? Vishnu does. As what? Dharmi. Dharma dharayita. So what does Shankara write? Dharma maryadam sthapayanna dharma dharayati. Yasya edasi tat tasya dharmaha. Whatever one naturally, instinctually a person has, that is his dharma. What is the dharma of Agni? Ushnasparshatvam. You touch it, you will know. You want to know the dharma of Agni? Put your hand. Immediately you will know the dharma of Agni. It is hot. What is the dharma of water? Shidasparshavatyaha apaha. It is cold to touch. Natural water is cold to touch. So every object in this universe has got a dharma. That is its swabhava, its nature. But what is the nature of Paramatma? Dharma itself. Dharma means what? That which helps you hold yourself. Suppose you take a stone and pour water thinking that it's Shivalinga. Had it been sand, what will happen? It will melt. It will run away. Why is that stone sitting there? Because of the dharma. Pashanatvam. Who is holding that stone together? Inside Antaryami Vishnu. He is the dharmi. He is the one who is doing this dharanam. So for the entire universe, who holds that dharma? Who is making the fire hot? Who gives that property to the fire? Dharmi. That is Vishnu. That is why he is called a dharmi. Because he provides dharma for the entire universe. Dharmagup, Dharmakrit, Dharmi. The next one is Sat. What is the next one? Sat. Sat means that which is. That which is. Sat means Satyam. What is the meaning of Sat? Satyam. Satyam means truth. What is truth? Trikala abaditam. One which cannot be dismissed at any point of time. For example, the sky. Sky is a truth. Why? Because your great-grandfather saw it. You are seeing it. Your great-grandson also will see it. So in any mode of time, the sky, it should not disappear. That is called truth. Vishnu is that. Vishnu is such because you cannot dismiss him in past, present or future. Trikala abhaditatva sat Vishnu. How do you know that? The Veda says that. Sadva idamagra asit, sadeva saumya idamagra asit. Hey saumya, hey child. Agre sad asit. In the beginning there was truth. And in the end also there will only be truth. That is why Vishnu is called as Sat. The next one is Asat. What is Asat? Asat means that which is not Satyam, that which is Maya. That is also him. Asat means Aparam Brahma. Sat means Param Brahma. What is Sat? Param Brahma. That which you cannot see. It is like electricity. You get the air. How do you get the air? Because of electricity. Electricity is like Param Brahma. Fan is like Aparam Brahma. The cause that is behind this universe, which you cannot see, is called Sat. Why do you need a Sat? Because you will be stuck with chickens and eggs. Which came first? Chicken or egg? So Shvetaketu went and asked his guru. He said, what was first? Sat or Asat? Bring me a seed. What seed? The seed of a banyan tree. Why a banyan tree? Because the mango tree seed is so big. The mango tree seed is that big. It's bigger than the mango. So he wanted a tiny, tiny thing. This banyan tree is so big, but the seed is very tiny. So he says, split it now. So he splits it. And he splits it and splits it. Finally, you see, what do you see? I don't see anything. That is Sat. That is Satyam. Where you cannot go beyond the chicken and egg. That is called Sat. It is the unseen cause. What is Sat? Behind the scenes cause. That is Sat. And what is Asat? What do you see? That is the after effect of Sat. That Asat is also Vishnu. The entire Vishwam is Asat. What is the entire Vishwam? Asat. That entire Vishwam is Vishnu. That Asat is also Vishnu. Sat is Vishnu, Asat is Vishnu. Why? Sadasat Ksharam Aksharam. Because he is Ksharam and Aksharam. Because he is Ksharam, he is Asat. Because he is Aksharam, he is Sat. What is Ksharam? What is Aksharam? Go to Gita, 15th chapter, 14th verse. Ksharas Sarvani Bhutani Akshara Purusha Smritaha Sarvani Bhutani Ksharani. Kshara means Vinashyam. Anything that has got a part is called Ksharam. Do you have a part? Then you are Ksharam. But if you think about your soul does not have a part. Why your soul does not have a part? Because you cannot drench it. You cannot dry it. You cannot penetrate it. You cannot kill it. It is Ajaha, Nityaha, Shashataha, Puranaha. That is you. That is your visiting card. Then whom you call this body? Because when you identify with the body, definitely the body has part. It is falling apart. That is Ksharam. The thing which does not go away, that is called as Aksharam. So Aksharam Sarvani Bhutani Aksharaha Purushaha. Purushaha means Pureshayaha. Who is entrapped in this? Who is inside this? But it's not entrapped. You are here because of your own sweet will. Nobody is forcing you to be in this body. You can go out any moment you want. That is why you are called a Purusha. A person who has entrapped himself out of his own sweet will. That is the meaning of Aksharaha. Akshara means Kutastham, Kutastaha, Kutastha Paramatma. Ksharaha means Sarvani Bhutani. Kshara Sarvani Bhutani, Kutastho Kshara Uchyate. That is Gita. Ksharaha means Sarvani Bhutani, all the created beings with parts, with avayava. Kutastaha Aksharaha. Who is the Kutastaha? Because of whom you are functioning. One who is sitting inside. Kutavati, like a magician. Unmoved, unchanged. That is Aksharam. The next line. Avijnata. Vijnata, the knower. Who is the knower? Who thinks that I am the doer. Who is the knower? Who thinks that I am doing everything? That is Jivatma. Atmani Kartrutvadi Vikalpa Vijnanam Kalpitam. Tat Vasana Guntitatva Jivaha Vijnata. That's what Shankara writes. Vijnata means Jiva. Jiva means the person who knows that I am the doer. I am suffering. I am little. I am unhappy. All this is said by the knower of this body. He is called Jiva. And Vishnu is what? Avijnata. He is different from that Jiva. That is why Vishnu is called as Avijnata. He does not know himself to be Karta. He says, Nakartrutvam Nakarmani. I am not a Karta. I don't have action. If you can also say that before retirement, then you have made it in this life. Then you also become Avijnata. Right now, what are you? Vasana Gunthi Tattvat. You have carried all your previous vasanas and you are yourself a Vijnata. And Vishnu is Avijnata. That's what we said in the Bhagavatam. Tasma Drishtari Drishtatvam. You are actually a Drishta. But you think you are Drishyam. What is Drishyam? That which is seen. You see me. So you think you are the seer, I am the seen. But you are also seen for other person. You also think you are the seen. At that moment, you stop believing that you are the seer. The moment you believe that you are not the seer, you become the seen. That is a cause of your problem. So what you have to do is, you have to ignore the seen. That is called avijnata. Who is an avijnata? One who ignores the optical illusion. If you can avoid all illusion, then you are avijnata. The next one is easy. Sahasram shuhu. One who has 1000 rays. That means what? The sun. Sahasram shuhu means the sun. Why is Vishnu called Sahasramshu? Because Aditya Gadaha Amshavaha Asya Eva Ayameva Mukhyaha Suryaha. The Surya is glowing with his glory because of the presence of Paramatma inside him. How do you know that? Yada Aditya Gadam Tejo Jagadbhasayate Khilam Tat Tejo Vidhimamakam. The nakshatras, the chandra, the surya, everybody is shedding their light. How does moon get the light? The borrowed light. The moon borrows the light from sun. How does the sun get the light? Borrowed from Paramatma. So who is the real Sahasramshuhu? Vishnu. That's why he is Sahasramshuhu. Then Vidhata. Dhata means one who holds. Vidhata means one who holds this entire universe. Who holds this entire universe? Seshaha. In the Hindu worldview, the entire world sits on Shesha, Adishesha. The Adishesha is carried by Kurma. Kurma is Mahavishnu. Hence, he is called as Vidhata. That is a Puranic story. The last one is Krita Lakshanaha. Krita means one who is made, one who is imagined. Lakshanam. Lakshanam means Shastram. So, if you want to know Vishnu, you should know his lakshanam. What is the lakshanam of Agni? Ushnasparshatvam. What is the lakshanam of cow? Sasnadimatvam. A drooping neck. No other creature has a drooping neck. Only cow has. In Sanskrit at least. So Sasnadimatvam gore lakshanam. Like that, Paramatma has got a lakshanam. Vishnu has got a lakshanam. What is that? Sat, Chit, Anandam. That is why he is called as Krita Lakshanaha. The entire Shastra is trying to talk about the nature of Paramatma. Hence, Paramatma is called as Krita Lakshanaha. Kritani Lakshanani Shastrani. Who created this Lakshanas, the Shastras? Vishnu. That is why he is called as Krita Lakshanaha. Kritaha means one who has made. Lakshana means Shastram. Who made the Shastram? Vishnu. Evam parampara praptam. I made this parampara. Krishna says that. I created this parampara. So all the lakshanas, all the shastras of Atma, of the self, was created by Vishnu. Hence Vishnu is called as Krita Lakshanaha. Susti prajabhya paripalayantam nyayena margena mahim mahisha. Go brahmanebhya shubhamastu nityam lokasmastha sukino bhavantu. Sarve bhavantu suginaha, sarve niramaya, sarve bhagavan pashyantu, mahakashchit dukkha bhavet, om shanti shanti shanti.